Hi everyone. Today I talk on a very different topic. Future of genetics in India, especially in the field of agriculture. And I will take you through a very, very cool topic of genetics. How many of you here are aware what it means? Do you really want to understand how we have been made? All living beings are made up of DNA, the deoxynucleic acid, and RNA, the ribonucleic acid. We are unique. Each person is different. Each person is beautiful. And they have their own genomic constitution, which determines all that. Having said that, you will wonder, you will ask me, how does it make a difference to you or me, or any other field? Well, genetics for a layman is study of genes, the genetic variations, heredity, and organisms. Now, you may ask me, genetics, organisms, environment, so many things I'm talking about. But yes, the genetics and the organisms are greatly influenced by the environment in which they thrive. Now, let me tell you or give you an example. If I give you two seeds, and these two seeds are planted in different climatic zones, like the temperate zone and the arid zone. The arid zone for you all is a place which lacks waterfall. Now, genetics says that both these seeds must grow to the same height. The sapling should be of the same height, but that does not happen. Here, we will see that the plant which grows in the arid climate will be stunted. The growth will be stunted. So, does that mean environment plays an important role also? Yes, of course. Genes and environment are two things which are individually connected to each other. So genetics, we are studying. We are studying how we can evolve and how we can make better produce, better crops in the pharma industry. And it has a very, very, very wide application. Coming back to agriculture. Agriculture is a field where the global population is growing each day. So that means the produce has to increase. The basic focus of every government across the globe is the socio-economic growth, the food produce. So what do we do here? Here comes the role of genetics and genetic engineering. But do we really expect that genetics can play a very, very different role here? Oh, yes. What happens in genetics? Genetics is molecular transformation and cloning. Cloning, you'll wonder, why do we need to clone? But here, when we talk of conventional plants, these conventional plants, they have all the genes, both the specific and the non-specific genes. But does that make a difference? Oh yes, it makes a lot of difference. Because when I'm genetically engineering or genetically modifying a plant, that is a transgenetic plant, I am putting in genes which are specific for increasing the produce, not only the quantity, but also the quality. This is not very, very well accepted across the globe at the moment, because people feel that why do we really need to genetically engineer something? Are we changing the constitution? Are we playing with nature? But here, I have a difference of opinion. If you really want to increase the produce, don't you all think that we must do something? And what is that something? That something is taking the best genes and creating these transgenetic plants so that not only the produce increases, but also the quality of the nutrition which each one of you gets increase. That means you grow up as healthy humans. So that is where we are really working hard and genetically modified plants are being used. Now, if I go ahead, there are about 10 to 30 million species of animals and plants all across the globe. But out of this, you will wonder when I say that only 19 or 20%, in fact, not even 20%, are the ones which are being utilized by humans. So that means these 19 or 20% must be greatly increased, modified to give us quality and quantity. Quality, of course, because if we don't have quality, do you think we would want to do something that does not give you any quality and just quantity? Here it comes that the farmers may think, but these days everybody is very educated and everybody wants not only a good produce, not only harvest, not only increase of their own profits, but they also want to sell something which they can talk about, be proud about the nutritional value of that product. So genetics here plays again a very, very important and key role. Having said this, I move forward and tell you that the next 30 to 40 years is going to be very tough. All of us have still good air, we still get water, we still have food. But can you imagine of the generation, the future generation which is coming? The future generation is going to be a place where there will be nothing, it will be a depletion of all these things. What do you do here? The land will remain the same. And we humans are creating concrete jungles where we are cutting the trees and we are playing with the environment. So here these genetically engineered products, these genetically engineered plants also help to regain the nutritional value of the soil, because here pesticides, the herbicides are not being used. The chemical fertilizers are being replaced by nano fertilizers. Now nano fertilizers is that the specific gene which helps in the produce is being produced here, put here. It is being molecularly cloned and transformed to create a plant which is much better, which is more sustainable, and which is also, you know, not infected by loci. That means we are thinking of the future. So we as genetic engineers think way ahead. We think to improve the environment, not only improving the nutritional quality, but also the not causing the air pollution, and making sure that the plants which we engineer are able to grow in areas which have less of water, less of nutrition, and so many other things. Now, have you ever thought that 30 to 40 years, why must I think about 30 to 40 years? I must just be thinking about today. Today I'm looking nice, I'm looking good, I'm talking to you all, that should be my aim. But is that so? That means I will be very selfish. I have to think ahead. I have to think of the future generation. I have to think of creating. It is not I here, in fact, it is we. All of us together, if we think about this, we think about changing, modifying, working together to improve each and everything. Won't that be good? As students here, don't you ever think that what could be your contribution towards the society? Why can't you take up this field of genetics in a much bigger and better way? Why can't we, especially today, I'm at Ludhiana, especially for this talk on genetics, right? Now, Ludhiana is a hub of industries. Also, there's a lot of agriculture which is in and around Punjab. Can we work on this? Can we really do something about it? Can we take up genetics majorly to improve the produce? So I would request each one of you to think about it, to come forward, do your bit, give the best you can back to society. And here, genetics, my dears, plays a very important role. Think about it, go back, read, see the beautiful pictures of the genomes, the genetic constitution you yourself have. And would you want to give the recombinant technology to the world? I would definitely say a yes. Here, I would end by saying, don't be selfish. Aspire to inspire before you expire. Thank you so much.